This is the game Dance Patterns. In this game, children copy a pattern of different movements and then try to predict what movements come next in the pattern. Playing Dance Patterns is a great way to get kids up and moving and to get them excited about patterns. To play, first, use your body to start a simple pattern like clap, stomp, stomp, and then have children repeat the pattern in unison. Clap, stomp, stomp, clap, stomp, stomp. Keep repeating the pattern until everyone has it down. Then, to add a bit of a challenge, during the pattern you can say to children, stop, or freeze, and then ask, okay, what comes next in the pattern? Trying to figure out the next movement helps children see that in patterns, they can predict what comes next. After kids get some practice with this game, they can start coming up with their own patterns and lead the group in acting them out. You can also use this game to show kids that you can make a new version of the same pattern using different movements. You can say, now can you make a new version of my pattern using different movements? So a pattern that's one movement and then another movement two times? Then one child might lead the group in jump, clap, clap, and another might do spin, jump, jump. Being able to transfer a pattern structure from one set of movements to another like this is a really important skill that will help kids a lot with later math. Now, when transferring a pattern from one set of movements to another, it can be helpful to describe the pattern using letters. A pattern can be represented with letters by assigning a letter to each unique item in the pattern's repeating unit. So if my pattern's repeating unit is clap, stomp, stomp, I could call it an A, B, B pattern, where the clap is represented by A and the stomp is represented by B. Or if my pattern's repeating unit is clap, stomp, spin, clap, I would call it an A, B, C, A pattern. Using letters to represent a pattern like this is a way to talk about the structure of repeating patterns. Instead of describing the pattern as something, then something else, then the second thing again, you can use letters and call it an A, B, B pattern. Preschool children don't need to use this type of letter representation. They can do all their dance patterns without ever hearing about this. But using letters to name the repeating unit of a pattern is a way to help us talk about the structure of patterns.